At Hirahurama. Penelope Fitzgerald was an English novelist, poet, essayist, and biographer. In 2008, The Times included her in a list of the 50 greatest British writers since 1945. In 2012, The Observer named her final novel, The Blue Flower, as one of the 10 best historical novels. Fitzgerald was the author of 9 novels. Her novel Offshore was a winner of a Booker Prize. A further 3 novels, The Bookshop, The Beginning of Spring, and The Gate of Angels, also made the shortlist. She was educated at Wickham Abbey and Somerville College, Oxford University, from which she graduated in 1938 with a congratulatory degree first.
Time, late 1920s, early 1930s. Place, Hirahurama, north of Auckland, New Zealand. Society, small, spread out towns with limited communication and transport options.
Tanner, an orphan from Lincolnshire, sent to New Zealand as a servant. He meets Kitty, his future wife, while at work. As they settle in, Kitty reveals that she is pregnant. During this period, he becomes much more nervous and fidgety, constantly running around and trying to get things done. However, that is out of determination to help his wife to the best of his abilities. Kitty, Tanner's wife, she met him while working as a servant. She persuaded Tanner to learn how to write and formed his base on which he could anchor to. During her pregnancy, she is remarkably calm and quiet.
Brinkman, Tanner's neighbor, he comes around twice every year to have dinner with him. However, by a coincidence, his visit is on the day that Kitty goes into labor. He blatantly refuses to leave without food, complaining that he was counting on this dinner. Although he is a pest, Tanner and Kitty manage to deliver the baby safely. The doctor. The local doctor has almost no business due to the low rates of illness in the area. He is concise and to the point and never wastes time. He is the one who finds that Tanner had accidentally thrown away the second baby and manages to save it. Parrish. A town local who is a pigeon racing enthusiast. Parrish lends 2 racing pigeons to Tanner in order to contact the doctor if needed. Mr. Tanner was anxious to explain how it was that he had a lawyer in the family, so that when they all decided to sell up and quit New Zealand, there had been someone they could absolutely trust with the legal business. That meant he had to say something about his grandfather.
At Hirahurama, written by Penelope Fitzgerald, begins the story of Tanner, his wife Kitty, Brinkman, their closest neighbor in the exceedingly remote rural communities of New Zealand, and the doctor to whom Tanner goes with news of Kitty's pregnancy. Fitzgerald's narrative tells of how Tanner and Kitty met, about how they moved to an isolated location, about Brinkman, whose twice-a-year visits assume a peculiar importance of Brinkman insofar as he comes to count on the 2 meals that accompany the 2 visits. About Tanner mistakenly thinking the afterbirth following the delivery of his daughter is now medical waste and proceeds to discard it, only to discover that the subsequent waste was actually another baby and how that second baby grew up to be a lawyer. The theme is the pioneering of life of the settlers in New Zealand. Tanner and his wife, both young and inexperienced, settle down in Hirahurama, a remote place. When it is time for their first child to be born, they have to be inventive in summoning the doctor. They get homing pigeons, which fly to their owner, who informs the doctor. But by the time the doctor arrives, the twins are born.
Ideas. Loneliness. Where they stay. Don't throw anything away. Tanner accidentally throwing a baby. Being prepared for the unexpected when Kitty is pregnant. Big things may come from small things. The baby that Tanner threw away, accidentally. Try to adjust with the situation, however difficult it is.
Literary devices. Well, don't ask me if it's going to be twins. Foreshadowing. Significance? This example of foreshadowing makes the reader want to read on and find out what exactly happens now that they have a clue or hint. Simile. Tanner came out of a bedroom covered with blood, something like a butcher. Significance? This example of a simile makes a reader visualize how Tanner would look like at this point in the story. It also makes the story more poignant, showing the couple's tribulations. Situational irony. Often by the time that I arrive, I am not needed. Significance? The doctor, in his conversation with Tanner, mentions that most of the time, he is too late to be of any use. However, he is the one that finds out that Tanner accidentally threw out the second twin. Situational irony. I'm going to look after the afterbirth. The father put it out with waste. Significance. This example of situational irony supports the theme, throw nothing away. Because he threw away the baby thinking it fails nothing, but it ended up being very successful.
Important quotations. Tanner turned over in his mind what he said to his wife when she told him she was going to have a child. Significance? Tanner already feels the strain of being responsible for a child, even though it is months away. This leads him to prepare for the baby hurriedly. Parrish didn't mind because Hiro Harama. Tanner's place was on more or less direct line from Awanui to Te Paki, and that was the line his pigeons flew. Significance? Parrish has allowed Tanner to use his pigeons to communicate with the doctor, unknowingly aiding him in saving his second twin's life.
Finale. The English writer Penelope Fitzgerald is perhaps remembered chiefly for her novels. The opening of a story provides the social and historical context. Mr. Tanner's grandparents had left for New Zealand. He has an apprentice and she as a governess, but both end up being little more than servants. They married and became farmers, settling in some poor and lonely countryside. Of their home, the narrator says forcefully, "Don't picture a shack farm." Consider the impacts of a narrator with her explicit interventions such as this, and, "But wait a minute, surely he couldn't read or write." The story certainly has its dramatic moments, the wife's cries, the husband covered in blood, and the twist towards the end of the story. How are you made to feel about the arrival of the character of Brinkman halfway through the story, his dominance thereafter, and his thoughts at the end of the story? Thank you for listening.
By Leroy
and Tyreek.
Thank you.